The Tab S7 Plus is designed for those people that want power but also want productivity. And number one, we want a huge screen. A lot of people, including myself, just want the biggest screen possible. Now, I've been using this tablet with Dex as my main computing source for the past couple of weeks, and I really have to say that this larger screen, this 12.4-inch OLED 120Hz panel, is a lot better for productivity, and I find myself doing more work on this actual tablet than I did on my previous tablet. But if you're buying this tablet not to be productive, but you're more on the gamer side or you're more on the multimedia side, watching your favorite Jabbertech YouTube videos, watching Netflix, playing your favorite game on the Tab S7 Plus has been an excellent experience. The Snapdragon 865 Plus processor takes anything you throw at it. There's no hiccups, there's no lag, nothing like that, thanks to the 8GB of RAM that I have on this 256 model. It also comes in 128 with 6GB of RAM or a whopping 512 with 8GB. But thanks to having a microSD card slot, if you need a little bit more space, you can go ahead and throw that in. On a side note, this is probably the last device that's going to have a microSD card slot from Samsung. Unfortunately, that card is dying. Unfortunately, that is no longer going to be an option for a lot of people when they buy a tablet or a phone. The screen, of course, from Samsung is one of the best panels that you can get. The blacks get really deep, the colors get very vibrant, and overall it's a very pleasurable experience. I've been using this tablet as my main computing source, so I haven't touched my laptop, I haven't touched my desktop. I've just been using the Dex experience, and I'm really very, very generally pleased with my experience using Dex. You have different windows, you can have a bunch of different windows, you can resize them, you can do whatever you want to do. I personally think Dex has come a long way since its inception. I think it still needs a long way to go to be a fully baked product to really make people get rid of their desktops and their laptops. But as of right now, I am super happy with Dex. I've been using it again as my main source for a computer experience, and I've been happy with it. Being able to resize windows and have certain windows in the forefront and do this and do that has been a really pleasurable experience. Over the past couple weeks, I did not feel the need to open up my laptop. This again was my sole experience, and I am happy to say if you want to use this again, if you're at work, as your main experience, you're going to be pretty happy with it. The S Pen itself charges from the back here, and you get a little icon when you place it on the back showing you that it's charging. If you buy a case for this tablet, which I'm sure 99.9% of you will, this is not going to be an issue. The case is going to ensure that your pen stays here, but if you don't use a case on this expensive tablet, well, you're just living on the edge, and your pen might fall off that edge as well, so I really recommend that you take care of this pen if you don't buy a case. Buying a case, though, protects that S Pen, and you'll be able to keep it here and keep it safe and protected. And this is the official Samsung keyboard. The keyboard itself supports gestures, so you can pinch to zoom, and you can also do a whole bunch of different things. The keys themselves feel really, really nice. So I do recommend this, and it's just an easier way, again, just to get into the office, plop this on your desk, start working in Dex right away. So I do recommend the keyboard. If you don't want to buy the official Samsung keyboard, I can recommend the Logitech K830, which has been a powerhouse of mine, and I've been using this for many, many years. It's Bluetooth, so you don't need any extra dongle or anything. You just connect it to your tablet via Bluetooth. You lose gestures on the trackpad, but if you don't necessarily want to carry around the tablet with a keyboard every single day and you want something a little bit more protective, I can recommend the Logitech keyboard personally. But again, if you are mobile and this is your main laptop, if you will, there's nothing wrong with the Samsung official keyboard. I think they designed a very, very nice keyboard for once. I wasn't really a fan of the other ones in previous generations, but they did an awesome job with this one. Again, it really depends on how you want to use this tablet, depends on your lifestyle and whatnot. But a keyboard with the Tab S7 is a definite must-have accessory. Now, if you don't want to use Dex and you just want to use the Android experience, you still can get a multi-view going on with the Tab S7 Plus. So really, depending on what you want to do, you really can do it on this tablet. Now again, some of the downsides to having a tablet with Android, of course, is something that has not been fixed. And that's that certain applications, like just look at Twitter. This is just a huge, huge version of your Android app for your cell phone. And that's the only drawback to Android tablets at the moment. I think developers really need to develop their apps for tablets. But again, Samsung really is the only game in town when it comes to tablets. And I don't think a lot of people do have Android tablets. That's why developers really haven't gone through the trouble of making sure that their apps resize properly or even making a fully legit tablet application. The four speakers on the Tab S7 do an excellent job. They get super, super loud thanks to that AKG tuning. And the screen is beautiful, as you saw in that YouTube video. It is an HDR Plus screen. So again, all the high tech that you'd want in a tablet or in any device really for 2020 or 2021, Samsung did not skimp on anything. This is a high-end tablet, and if you buy it today, there's no doubt it's going to last you many years in the future. The Tab S7 Plus has everything you'd want again, so you get Wi-Fi 6, Bluetooth 5 with that dual audio, so that means that if you're on a plane or you're just sitting at home and you want to share the audio experience of whatever you're watching with someone else, you can go ahead and connect two Bluetooth headphones to it. That's something super useful. I've used that a bunch of times when traveling, and now thanks to having a bigger screen, I'm going to have my own movie-like experience 10,000 feet up in the air. So I really think that's a great experience. The Tab S7 Plus I was going to give a lot of crap to when I did my unboxing because, well, they only included a 15-watt charger in the box and it's not even USB-C to USB-C. You get the old USB-A, Samsung probably's got a ton of these lying around, and they decided to throw it in this super expensive tablet. Unfortunately, I can't give them as much crap as I wanted to because, well, a lot of devices are not even coming with a charger these days, so I guess we should be thankful that Samsung gave us their super slow charger in the box. Thankfully, though, you can go ahead and get something like this from Aukey. This is a 100-watt charger with two USB-C inputs and two USB-A. So with 100 watts, you're going to be able to charge this at its full capacity, which is 45 watts. Now at 45 watts charging, it will charge in about an hour and a half. And if you use this super slow charger that they've included in the box, it's going to take very close to 4 hours to get a fully charge. Now Samsung does have a 25 watt charger that they really should have included, but they didn't. They gave us this slow charger. So I really think it's worth just spending the extra couple bucks, getting something again like this Aukey charger, and you're going to have more power than you know what to do with. You're going to be able to charge up your brand new S21 Ultra and your S7 Plus at full capacity. So I think that's a shame that Samsung put a 10,000 milliamp hour battery in here, but chose to give us a super slow charger. They could have at least given us that 45 watt charging, but it is capable of fast charging. So I highly suggest you just spend that couple extra dollars and save yourselves about 3 hours worth of charging time, 3 hours worth of waiting. But that's really the only downside that I can see to this tablet. Everything else has been a really pleasurable experience. This is a massive screen at 120 hertz and such a vibrant panel at that. It does take a lot of battery. I wish I could say it sips battery, but it definitely doesn't. Standby time though, Samsung did a really good job with standby. So my standby times is, I get a couple days out of this. So if I'm just using this as a couch surfer, I can easily get 4 to 5 days worth of battery. Again, just picking it up when I get home, surfing the web, answering emails, that sort of thing. But if I am using this as my desktop replacement, which I have been doing, if I make it through the entire day, I'm lucky. Again, it all depends on what you're doing. If you're playing a lot of games, if you're watching a lot of multimedia, but my average is about 8 hours of battery on this massive tablet. So that is an entire workday. And again, thanks to being able to fast charge, I'm not really too concerned about charging this up. If you are just using this as a couch surfer or just a casual tablet, you definitely will get multi-day usage on it. Again, depending on if you're playing games, depending if you're doing a lot of Zoom calls or whatnot. Now let's talk about cameras since I mentioned Zoom calls. Thankfully, Samsung did put the camera in landscape mode because most of the times this is going to be on your desk just like this, and it makes it very easy to take those Zoom calls. On the back, you do get some camera lenses. Now I'm not a proponent of taking this out in the wild, but if you do, it's a 13 megapixel shooter, and it's also a 5 megapixel ultra wide. The megapixels on the front is 8. So again, definitely not high-end cameras, but they're not low-end either. You're going to be able to look fine on those calls, and if you want to take a quick snapshot of a document so you can mark it up, you're going to be able to get some decent resolution from it. But I think this is a great device. If you're looking for an awesome tablet, if you're looking for something maybe a little bit smaller, check out the S7, but I still recommend the S7 Plus, even for this larger screen. I think no matter what you do on it, your experience level is just heightened. You get a more enjoyable experience thanks to having a larger screen. And if you're looking for a great multimedia beast, if you're looking to be a productive monster, or if you're looking for anything in between, the Tab S7 Plus is going to be your best friend. No matter what you throw at it, this is going to be able to play it because, again, this is a powerhouse. The 865 Plus and Wi-Fi 6 means that you're going to be able to do everything super, super fast. Samsung didn't skimp other than giving us this slow-ass charger in the box, but that's an easy fix once again. Thanks to the guys at Aukey for sending me over this 100 watt charger. This is going to be able to solve all of your charging needs and cut that charge time from 4 hours down to about an hour and a half. So that's definitely worth it when you're in a pinch. But other than that, guys, it's an awesome buy today. It's going to be an awesome buy tomorrow. If you are interested in picking this up, which I'm sure you are since you're watching my video, check the link down below. If you have any questions, let me know down there as well. But I appreciate you guys watching. Thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll catch you guys next time.